you know that I've known you forever. How many nights we hung out together? See, little crowd, little bar, little town, round this old dance floor. My boys are laughing, tap me on the shoulder.
It's such a surreal moment, you know, with the bigness of it. And you know that, yeah, there's only a few faces in front of you, but you also know that there's millions of faces that are watching in the moment as well. And that never gets lost on you at all. And it's intense, but it's also that kind of intenseness that you crave as an artist. Like you want to have those moments where you feel your heart flutter, you feel that sense of like, this is bigger than just anything. I mean, this is the biggest thing I've ever done by like a lot. So it's awesome.
Jim, I didn't even think about the millions of people at home. In my mind, it's like the four coaches and like a couple squares. And I'm like, I don't think about that. So thank you for now putting that in my mind. To answer your question about it being real, honestly, to me, it doesn't make a difference live versus blinds. I think it's still kind of the same amount of nerves, just in a different way. But definitely every time I step up there, I'm reminded this is real. You know, you've got cameras zooming by you. I'm just so grateful. I don't know. This is really, tonight was a roller coaster for me specifically. And so I'm just thankful to be on this end of it. And it's definitely very real. I felt that today for sure.
You know, it's a really humbling experience. You see all the work of thousands of people. And, you know, for all of us, we know dozens and dozens of artists who have lost all their tours. And we're some of the luckiest musicians in America to have this stage. And it's like the mythical Narnia stage, you know, and here we are. It's very humbling. And, you know, it's an honor to be there.
I mean, for me, it's like, it's about like tension and release. So it's like when I get up there and there's all those nerves, it's like I'm bottling them up into this little thing that I put all the energy in. And then I have this big release. The stage itself, it doesn't feel the intenseness of the emotions, because I experience them to a really intense degree. It is not different than in any other show that I've ever done. Cause I get that worked up about every show. So that's kind of what it feels like for me. I mean, it's just as, you know, I get just as intense about playing, anything, a farmer's market or a Walmart. You know, if I was playing a Walmart, I've never played a Walmart. I don't know why I said that. but if I did, I would feel just as intense about
that. It might go viral. Why don't you give it a whirl?
Yeah, I mean, apparently that's the thing you can do. You can play Walmarts and
I don't know.
Get an Ed Shapiro contract. I bottle up all that energy and explode, which is actually a really good song by Elliot Smith called Bottle Up and Explode. It's that feeling, but yeah, just really channeling that energy and releasing it. And it sucks that it's only a 2-minute and 50-second song to do that. You know, normally you get a whole show to do that. So it's a lot of energy and it's really intense for a very short amount of time. And then it's released and then you feel great. And that's what we're all chasing, is that feeling. So John, he's a great, he's known as he's a great arranger. Like that's what he does. You know, he's a choral director and things like that. So he's got that element of like arranging songs that you get. Kelly is the only one of the coaches that's actually been through this process before. So you get her wisdom of actually like being through this. You know, she's done this before. This isn't her first rodeo. So she's got that wisdom that goes there. And Blake, you know, you pick up from him just his like quick wit. And his ability to think on his feet. I don't know. That's just, I feel like that's a quality that he just has. It's not necessarily a musical quality, but it's definitely a quality that that I think shines through in everything that he does. He's just very quick-witted, and he's sure of who he is and what he's doing, and that can translate definitely into your music.
Yeah, Blake's got a very humble attitude, and he has a way of just keeping everything light. But the main thing that I've personally got with him is just to keep going and pushing for authenticity and, you know, trying to bring out, you know, your originality in everything you do.
Yeah, it's not much different what Ian said. I mean, that's the thing, is what you see on camera is the same guy that's behind the camera. I mean, off camera. It's all about being genuinely you and not trying to live up to a show or trying to live up to some crazy expectation. But, you know, like, he constantly tells me, like, Jim, just be you. Like, you know, like, and I know that sounds so, like, simple. But when you're in this situation and you're with all these unbelievable artists and singers, it's easy to kind of get caught up in it and trying to do something else that's out of your thing, or, you know, and he genuinely just wants you to be the best you that you can be. And you kind of see that in the way that he does it as well. I mean, he's one of my favorite performers as far as like genuinely sounding the same all the time. Like, if you see him in concert, you're going to hear a quality that lives up to what you hear on the radio or anything else. And he tries to pull that out of us. And I think that's just seeing that in real life, seeing that in person inspires you to like, yeah, I want to be the best me. I don't want to try to overreach, but I also don't want to like, you know, not do what I'm capable of doing. It's this fine balance that he kind of really encourages you on to like do your best, but not settle for anything less than that.
I love that. That was so great. I think, like Jim said, it's really difficult, this competition, because you feel like you need to go out there and sing a Whitney Houston song. And when you realize that you're enough and what you do is enough, it's not called the big voice, it's called the voice. So like Ian and Jim say, totally just being true to you. For me, Blake has always said that I always swing for the fences. And so just feeling supported by him to do that, I always try to add as much of me as I can to any song that he throws my way. And I'm always like, should I have done that high note there or no? Like, he just supports me and my ambition. And I think that's really important when I step on the stage, that I'm making him proud, and that I'm, like they said, I'm being true to who I am and what I want to be as an artist. And he definitely encourages that.
Yeah. Well, so I'm like, you know, I'm very new to the team, so I haven't had as much of the one-on-one instruction with Blake. So a lot of what I gather from Blake is from what I've seen him doing with other people. But yeah, it would be just, you know, like being true to what you're doing. And, you know, if it happens to be country, cool. If it's not, he's okay with that too. So just, you know, yeah, the whole thing of just being your authentic self, and, you know, nobody can be better at being you than you.